Welcome to another draft here on channelfireball.com, sponsored by Ultimate Guard, of course. It's a proud sponsor of Team CFB. And we're going to be first picking Mana Crypt here. Not going to wheel our Thraven Inspector, sadly. What's leaving? Don't really care about Rafellas too much. There's a Windswept Heath, Gruul Signet, Ancient Grudge, Deese Deese. Hey, thanks for the raid, MTG Salseo. ¿Cómo estás? Take a little Mana Crypt action here. Thraven Inspector is power. Yeah, something like that. I like when I get to play Bazaar Baghdad in my decks, but I don't tend to first pick it. Ooh, I think I'm in for Warren Power Stone here. It's one of the better cards in the pack, though it's just staying enlarged. There's also Nissa, but I'm not in for that. I mean, Nissa's fine, obviously, but Warren Power Stone is decent. Oh, there, now we can Upheaval, and this is a great start to Upheaval. There we go. I love it. There's also a Dimir Signet, but at this point, Upheaval is just looking so good in the deck, so I am quite happy with this start. Little mono brown. My favorite flavor of Spindrift is the Arnold Palmer flavor, but I like all of the flavors. They're all very good. Mango's probably the worst. I like Warren Power Stone more than Simic Signet when I have a Mana Crypt, because then I'm going for actually exactly this sort of thing. Ooh, there's Preordained, but there's also Mishra's Workshop. Huh. Mishra's Workshop's really good with Warren Power Stone. Tends to be good with the kinds of cards I want in my Mana Crypt deck. It's really one of those two, and I don't think Workshop's going to wheel, because the rest of this pack is pretty bad. I don't think Workshop's going to wheel. I think I'm just going to take the shop, yeah. Also, the big mana decks might not always have early blue quite as often. They have a lot more colorless lands, but now there's Metalworker. There's also Thirst. I took Workshop. I'm just going to take Metalworker. I'm not worried about trying to wheel stuff. This is a start. This is a nice start. I like what we got here. Workshop Metalworker is a classic. The first, like, basically the second season of PTQs I ever played, and I was pretty new to PTQing, Metalworker was in one of the better decks. There's the Tinker. This is extended back when, like, Tinker was legal, Goblin Recruiter was legal, Oath of Druid was legal. Basically, Hermit Druid, all the nonsense. Like, 15 cards got banned eventually out of that format or whatever. But I loved playing the Metalworker Tinker decks with, like, Lightning Greaves and Grim Monoliths and Ancient Tombs and stuff like that. A lot of fun. So now there's Impulse and Orzhov Signet. This is kind of like the Workshop Preordained pick, but both cards are worse now. I kind of feel like I'm supposed to just take Signet when I have Workshop and Metalworker, though. I don't know. It's not the best Signet, but I actually do find this deck splashes white a lot because Balance and Fracture Identity are both, well, Fracture Identity is just a busted card, but Balance is also really good in this deck, and so I think that it ends up they end up being in the same decks. Now I'll probably take Miscalc, because Miscalc is a nice that you can cycle it. I don't value Seachrome Coast all that highly. And Miscalc is just a very good card. I would love to pick up a Golos. Workshop Mana Crypt Golos game. Yeah, oh yeah. I actually like Armageddon in these style of decks too, Ryan, but not enough to for second pick it over Warren Power Stone, of course. I haven't found Bazaar to be good in these decks, Bucky Curls. Like, you would need, I think, Crucible of Worlds to really make Bazaar good, but here I actually might just take Elesh Norn. Oh, I would love Shodan of the Scalds BK. That's a great point. That's one of the best points you've ever made. There's also Wear Tear, but I actually like Elesh Norn. This deck can actually cast Elesh Norn. It's a sideboard card, but it's good to have here. Uba Mask. I remember Uba Stacks, yeah. Yeah, this is looking like a pretty good start. I'm pretty into it. Ooh, there's Smokestack. Wow, Windswept Heath wheeled. Huh. There's also Grudge and Bazaar. I did not encounter Windswept Heath wheeling here. The mana's not great, but Smokestack is just so bad. Like, this isn't the right color of fetch. I wouldn't really be thinking of this, obviously. It was like a blue fetch or something, but all right, whatever. I'm in for Smokestack. It's bad. I know that Heath is just a better pick there, but, like, you know, we're here. Ooh, Mazavith. Though Seasoned Pyromancer is a combo of Smokestalk. I think I'm just going to take Mazavith still, though. Lapse of Certainty, I actually think, is good in White Weenie, but it's not very good outside of it. White Weenie getting a card that delays their whatever they're trying to do by a turn, I think, is actually pretty strong. It's good with Geddon, too. Lapse them, then Geddon, so they can't replay it. I mean, Memory Lapse would be really good. I'm going to take Face Fetters and probably not play it. There's also Tithe Taker. Tithe Taker is good with Smokestack, but I'd rather just have another anti-aggro sideboard card. Yeah, nonsense, whatever. Same with, I guess, Lyra. My mono white sideboard. Oh, that's a late Cultivate. There's also Shatterskull Smashing. I think I'm going to take Cultivate. I don't know. Maybe I should have taken Smashing because I do kind of like Nahiri. Oh, last pick Seachrome Coast? Okay, I'm in for that. It's a Firebolt down there. Probably just supposed to take Dynamo over Remand. As much as I like Remand, I mean, when you have Workshop and Metalworker and like Mana Crypt, I think you just Dynamo here. Shelldock is fine, but this deck doesn't look like it's going to draw lots of extra cards, so I think I'm just going to take the Dynamo. Like, Upheaval's looking gross in this deck. I'm going to have to put Nahiri out of here, because as of right now, I'd rather not play Nahiri. Like, I would love to just be Mono Blue if I can get away with it. Is Top not OP in Cube? It is not OP. I would say 2/3 of decks that play Sensei Divine Top should not put them in their deck. Oh, Golos Alert. I actually would play Emrakul in this deck. We're looking like we're pretty thick on mana. But I'm gonna take Golos here. And then there's Wishclaw Talisman is also a kind of interesting card. Oh, there's Urza. Oh, it is all coming together here. Not even close to anything else. Boom. Mono Blue Storm, baby. We want this deck would love a Tolarian Academy, which is good because most decks don't want Academy. And then there's also, I would love Caracas here with the Urza and Golos. Probably taking Fafhrs at this point. It's that or Cosima, God of the Void. It's pretty close, honestly. Because like, if you can play Metalworker and then play, or play Omen Keel, then play Metalworker to crew the Omen Keel. Like, that's going to be pretty strong. Actually, maybe I should... I'm just going to take Foth, obviously. I wouldn't mind wheeling one of those colorless lands, too. Would not be bad. Okay, there's Tanglewire, but this is actually a pretty strong pick, or pack, right? With Bolt, Glorybringer, Blood Crypt, Sun Titan. These are all like fine cards. So I might just take Narset, because it's actually looking pretty solid in this deck, and then try to wheel Tanglewire. Because I actually would play Tanglewire in this deck as it stands, but I think I'm supposed to take Narset here. Plus, this deck would love like a Time Spiral or something. Now I think I probably take the off-color Signet, because I do want to be able to activate Golos off Signets if possible. And there's a chance I play a White Splash. I don't like Treasure Cruise in this deck. There's Everflowing Chalice, which obviously has a pretty high upside, but I think also White Signets in particular are good here, because Balance is a card I'm actively looking for at this point. I don't know. I've got a lot of big colorless things. I think that having another White Signet is going to be good in this deck, especially with Golos. I don't think I want Lotus Bloom here. I don't really want any of these cards. Maybe Field of Ruin. Mishra's Factory? Field of Ruin could fix... I don't know, Field of Ruin is kind of nice with like Golos or something. I guess Mishra's Factory is also nice with Golos. Yeah, sure. Sure. Oh man, Mom Spaghetti? Duretti is really, really strong. Mirari Conjecture is looking terrible in this deck, so I'm not taking that. Marsh Flats looks dubious. There's also a raid. Oh, there's also Tez. I kind of blanked over Tez, because I never play Tez, but actually Tez looks okay here. I don't really have a good target to get with Tez. I guess I can get Metalworker. Yeah, we're not gonna actually be able to cast it already. Let's just take Tezzeret. You also so rarely get to put Tezzeret in your deck. All right, well, this deck does actually want Sensei's Divining Top. I just like talked a bunch of smack about Sensei's Top, but it's good with Tez. It's actually like a card that this deck will play. I'll take Wishclaw. If I have the mana for Wishclaw, then it could actually be good. Ooh, Burning to go with that Boros Signet. Burning is really good in this deck. I don't know about the mana for burning, but oh, Plateau Wield. Okay, I'll take Plateau. Oh wait, no. Hold on. Second Wildfire. BK, I know you're going to talk about Wishclaw Talisman and Upheaval. Don't worry about it. Hey, later, Mole. I'm just going to take the second Wildfire here. I would love the mana. Oh, Tanglewire Wield. So did Blood Crypt, oddly enough, but that's okay. I don't care. Oh, burning into Wildfire is a good sign, yeah. Okay, so these are all the five pluses. Wow, this Boros Signet pick over Chalice is looking really good with those two. Gotta say. Electromancer, me. I like Time Warp with Tezzeret and I guess with Narset and Urza. So Time Warp is pretty solid in those cases. I probably should just take Bribery though. On balance, I think casting Bribery is going to be better than either of those. I really want this Azorius Signet. Is it crazy to take Signet here? Like, I've got double Burning and Upheaval and Tezzeret. I've got all these like really strong cards. Yeah, all right. I wanted to take the Signet, so I was really glad Justin said Signet because that's what I wanted to do. Ooh, you would not believe what BK says on Discord when he plays this card. But I'll take Lodestone Golem. It's good with all the Signets and in Mishra's Workshop and Metalworker and all that stuff. There's also a Golgari Signet, but that's like a pretty loose Signet for this deck, though I would obviously still play it. Emrakul, Aeon's Tarn. That's going to get a little ambitious, whereas Scalding Tarn is good because I really do want to play Burning and Wildfire in this deck. They look really good here. So, nah, Emrakul to Aeon's Tarn, way too expensive. Oh, Balance. I have Seachrome Coast, Orzhov Signet, Boros Signet, Azor. Yeah, Balance is just going to be obscene in this deck. Like, so many mana artifacts here. And then I like that Rakdos Signet too, but Balance is just is looking really, really good. You also even have like Sensei's Top to like hide cards there. Like, the whole point with Balance is you're supposed to just hide your cards on the board in the form of artifacts that don't get equalized. Mm-hmm. This deck is looking really good. Like, that, you know, that last deck that we had, the like blue green, the Teemer Storm deck that kind of got there barely on the skin of its teeth. That deck was like okay, but this deck is really, really good. Squirrel's just a narc. How many artifacts are in this deck right now? 3, 5, 8, 12. We're getting a little late to get Talarian Academy here. We have four more picks. I would love more Signets. I'm really glad I took that Azorius Signet now that I picked up Balance here. Would I play Burgi in this deck? Because the Horn of Plenty in this deck? With like Burning and Wildfire. Horn of Plenty plus Balance? Tinker. That's an interesting one. I don't have a good target to get. My best target's Golos. I wouldn't say this is a legacy deck given I have Mana Crypt and Mishra's Workshop. I might just take Ballista here. I need to ask the Cube Council, BK and Justin, what are your votes? I was also Wandering Fumeral, not an unreasonable vote given the thing. All right, the Cube Council has weighed in and Ballista is what I wanted to take. Oh man, Memory Jar versus Steam Vents. This isn't really a Chrome Mox deck. I don't probably have enough colored sources. This is 22 playables right now. I think it's just going to be Steam Vents here. I want to be able to cast my Wildfires. Wildfire is so good. Probably not fast bonding. I don't really like Academy Ruins, but this actually might be an Academy Ruins deck in a strange twist of fate. Because I have Ballista, which is pretty strong with Ruins, and Golos can go get Ruins. And Force of Negation is going to be a stretch with five. There's also Pyroclasm. Pyroclasm is a totally reasonable pick, but I actually kind of think Academy Ruins could be good here. Is that crazy? Yeah, I'll take Pyroclasm. Fine. Fun Police. I don't even know if I want to main deck this Clasm. Oh, see? Should have taken Academy Ruins. It's a Mindslaver. I'm just going to take Winter Orb, though. Winter Orb, I think, is going to be good with... It's actually pretty gross with Tanglewire. And it's good with Urza. And it's a fetchable thing with Tezzeret. I actually lost... As you remember the stream a couple streams ago where my opponent went Tez -2, get Winter Orb, and it just completely boned me. I'll take Elspeth Conqueror's Death and not really plan on playing it. Oh, I could also... I wouldn't play Temple Garden. The question is, would I play a basic Plains? Because if I am going to play a basic Plains, Temple Garden is a nice pickup to just make Golos a little bit better. Right now, I don't have any black sources. How likely... I'm not going to play Elspeth Conqueror's Death. I just don't see a world... Oh, Golgari Signet. Yes. I mean, Chandra Torture Defiance is really good. But Golgari Signet, I think... I don't know. I think with all these burnings and stuff, just taking a Signet has to be great. Oof, do I hose their Planeswalkers? Or do I just take Incinerate here? I think I'll just take Incinerate. Also Beaumont Courier. Mortars is a fine sideboard card. Don't think I want Stirring Wildwood. Late Goblin Welder. Not inconceivable that I play that, I suppose. That was a late Chandra for sure. I don't think Double Red's going to be that hard in this deck. Because I've got a lot of lands, including two blue-red lands. Yes, I agree that my deck is too good for Beaumont. Yep. So this is 25. I'm kind of looking at cutting this Goblin Welder. I do like Welder with Golos. You can't weld back Ballista, but you can shoot down to a 1-1 and weld it out. Obviously, it works okay with Tanglewire and Smokestack. Yeah, Welder Winter Orb is also a combo. Cut Smokestack. I actually think Smokestack might be okay here. Like, I have a lot of, like, kind of garbagey permanence this act to it. I guess I would have liked a Crucible as well. I don't believe Welder Mindslaver is much of a combo. It's the same reason I don't think Academy Runes Mindslaver is all that much of a combo. I think the 3-6 drops are good. Like, I don't think I want to cut any of those, and I'm not going to cut any of the Signets or Winter Orb. I think Miscalc is good. Balance is great. I'm kind of looking at the Welder here. You can tap and top and weld it in response. Top, I think, is good. I think top is good for a few reasons. I've got Narset and Urza to kind of shuffle, Golos to shuffle. I also can fetch it with Tezzeret if I just need some action. I think I'm going to play 16 lands plus Mana Crypt here. How good is Tez here? Tez looks better than Welder. Welder's currently on the chopping block here. I'm not going to cut any of the artifacts. And I guess I could actually see cutting Narset. Huh. My mana's going to be good enough for Narset. No, she's going to be really good. It's going to be like Smokestack or Goblin Welder here. Miscalc's good. Miscalc, I think, is worth playing. It's just so flexible. You can all cycle it here. Oh my god. I knew that BK was going to be angling for this Wishclaw Talisman. Oh, and you can weld it out in response. Oh, you can Wishclaw and then upheaval it. Oh, you can Wishclaw and then... I don't even know what other things in the BK voice we're going to do. So right now, I've got two blue-red lands and a blue-white land is my fixing. As well as a Misha's Workshop. Currently, I'm not playing Maze of Ith, not playing Misha's Factory. If I play Field of Ruin, I also play like a Plains, two Mountains, and the rest Islands or something. I'll play three Mountains. Let's see. 5, 6, 9, 10. Then six Islands is 9 blue. I have one blue Signet and one red Signet, and then the rest are white. I'm not actually loving this Field of Ruin now that I'm looking at it. Like, because I could just not play the basic Plains, because I don't really want to do that either. You thought I wasn't having BK on the stream till Friday. This is two. Because right now I have 2, 3, 4, 5 white sources for balance, not counting Golos or Tezzeret, both of which can get white sources. All right, I think Welder out. Like, I'm basically splashing for the two double red cards, but they're really good in this deck. I might side them out. There's a lot of matchups where I'll side them out, but... So yeah, I think I want to do something like this. This is 3, 4, 5 red, 6 red. Oh, no, I actually kind of want 7 red. And then this is 7. This is 10 blue sources. I do not think Factory is good in this deck. What is Factory doing in this deck that's particularly special? Like, the fact that it counts as an artifact in play doesn't actually do anything. I guess it buffs the Urza's Golem token. That's about it. Why play a Temple Garden? Because I want one more white land, and it's also a green land for Golos, which means if I have two black signets, I can go. I guess one of the black signets is also a green signet. Who knows? Golos activations also look pretty reasonable in this deck, yeah. I mean, it's possible I should cut Temple Garden just because I don't want another white source, in which case I just play the Seagrim Coast. But Balance is such a good card that I don't mind playing like slightly above the number of white sources I would normally want because of how good Balance is. There's also Nahiri in the sideboard, but I don't think I want Nahiri right now. Against creature decks, I can board in like Mortars and Pyroclasm, which is nice. Against decks where Wildfires are bad, I'm like a little more stuck at that point. I'm probably building in the Wet Welder Wishclaw package, actually. I think that actually would be good. Upheaval. So, Zaphod, if you're asking, if you're saying a lot of permanents that want to stay in play is a reason not to play Upheaval, you're not really looking at Upheaval correctly. The way to look at Upheaval is how much mana can I generate? If your deck can generate like 10 plus mana on the reg, which this deck definitely can, Upheaval is fantastic. Because you just go Upheaval, replay Dynamo, replay Warden, Power Stone. They have nothing in play and you have 6 mana already. Upheaval is probably the single most powerful card in this deck. Like, Balance is close because it's so cheap, but Upheaval gets you out of basically any board situation with enough mana. So don't look at Upheaval as like, oh man, I'm going to bounce my like Golos or Urza or whatever. But like, this is just Upheaval with tons of mana. Like, imagine I have a Dynamo and an Urza in play. All of a sudden, I'm just going to cast Upheaval, floating enough mana to replay all my cards. And then they're just going to play a land and discard 4 cards and be done. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Kaldra, none of the things you said are really close to being worth it. Exactly. Mola knows. Pilsner Fox, you've the mono red like prison deck, and now that Simian Spirit Guide is banned, I think you probably might want to go back to the drawing board. That deck leaned pretty hard on Simian Spirit Guide. Honk Bonkington, welcome. Well, Balance also is underplayed a little in cube because it's kind of hard to use Balance correctly. It's not trivial to make it, like, in this deck it's ridiculous. But in your average, like, just cube deck with white cards in it, I don't think Balance is actually that good. Yeah. Cowards. Yep, Simian Spirit Guide, no longer legal and modern. I would like to play first. And one land and 3/6 drops. No bueno. Yeah, this works. Mm-hmm. This isn't really where I want to be, but I get to go turn 3 Metalworker. Yeah. Shoulder of the Scald would have been a nice pickup. I actually don't even know if it would be good in this deck. Here, because I have no other fast lands, I'm just going to lead an island, so I lessen my vulnerability to Wasteland. Oh yeah, we have better hands than this. This is certainly true. Do we have to be careful or mindful since Tezzelt and Blister are only real win conditions? No. Not really. Let's go ahead and, because our win conditions are just like Upheaval is like one of our primary win conditions. Ooh, Golgari Signet was a nice draw. Like, I might Upheaval next turn. It's not inconceivable that that happens. Like, getting to, so I have 3, if I draw an artifact, I go up to 9 mana. I'll be able to Upheaval, replay a land, so it's 10 mana, and then replay a bunch of my stuff. Like, Birds is obviously like decent at fighting against Upheaval, but like if they play like a Polukranos or something, like hopefully this Metalworker lives. Metalworker's a pretty nice card if it lives. Oh, channel. I don't like that. That's not a good sign. There are some things that Upheaval will let me beat that they could channel out, but obviously, like, most likely I'm dead here. If it's like an Avenger of Zendikar or something, then like we could still win. Though I guess you wouldn't play the land first. I'm not sure. Like, it's not a Finale of Devastation because they already attacked with the Scavenging Ooze. I would not beat Emrakul or any of the Ulamogs because they would all just eat the Metalworker. I think I'd be okay against Primeval Titan. Channel Gargaroth.com, huh? Okay, well, that one... that one I think we can beat. Let's see. So if we... I mean, Upheavaling is still probably fine here, right? I have 8 mana. I say just Upheaval and Signet. Yeah... It would have really been really nice to draw an artifact. I mean, I could Foff, but I don't... No, I think I'm just going to Upheaval here. Look, they had a kind of janky channel, and look, we're going to have a kind of janky Upheaval. we'll trade. I guess I actually still should have just played Basic Island under the same logic here. But they're obviously most likely just to play Forest Birds anyway. Land... I think I still play Metalworker here because the odds, like if I draw an artifact, Metalworker can still just completely pop off. And if they play like Scavenging Ooze again, like this just really does not matter. All right, so now, so I have a couple ways I could do this. I could Metalworker reveal 4. Let's see. I don't really want to Narset into Scavenging Ooze all that much. I could play a land and cast Factor Fiction and then try to really Metalworker. I guess, that lets me Tangle Wire too. Yeah, okay, never mind. That's just going to be way better. Let's just Foff. And then they're not going to put the two artifacts next to each other, but I'm pretty happy here because I'm probably going to play. So now I can just, I'm going to keep this pile. But I'm not going to play Lodestone Golem yet. I'm going to reveal these 3, and I'm going to go Warn Power Stone into Tangle Wire. And then now I know they're not doing anything next turn. And then I can play Lodestone Golem plus Narset or something on the next turn. I think I have enough mana for that. Yeah, because I can play the Narset easily, because I can even play the Narset before playing Lodestone. Lodestone versus 4 was also reasonable, yes, for sure. So here you want to make sure you fade first. Oh, I guess it's not easy because I do have to tap some permanents, but whatever. I think we'll be fine here. So I'm going to tap these 3, draw 4. So I still think I play Narset here because it also Narset also helps with Tangle Wire. I don't have the red yet, but it's okay. Soon. Wildfire is just gonna wipe my opponent's board here. So they're gonna tap 3, but now they have access to 3 mana plus a land drop, so 4. But then I have a Lodestone Golem in play, so I do need to find a red mana to do this, but. I don't think this is... Narset, it's not... Sorry, you can't tap Narset. Never mind. I was just looking at permanents. Helps with Smokestack. Do that. I guess I could Narset into like a... No, my red signet's on the bottom. Whatever. We'll see what we can Narset into. Smokestack? Yeah, that's probably better than the white signet. Play Smokestack. Or bin, not bottom, whatever. I think I leave up Miscalc. I don't care about Narset getting attacked. It doesn't really do much. I'll play the Signet. It's kind of close playing the Signet versus leaving it to reveal off Metalworker. Like it does tap for more mana kind of in hand, but I don't know. We're getting to the point where That's not really a really a thing. Wasn't Smoke's card a bad card to let inside? I don't know what that means. I'm not cycling Miscalc. Countering their next big play, like, I mean, I can just counter Gargroth this turn, is going to be pretty valuable. If it's not Gargaroth, okay, this looks like it is Gargaroth. It would be worse. I mean, if I can counter Gargs and draw a red source, obviously, like, it's just going to be brutal here. Oh, they're done. They lost the will to live. Was I going to draw a red source? Oh, pfft, never mind. I was going to draw Ballista. I think Shodan of the Scalds is pretty cool in this cube, to be honest. All right, so I'm going to want to put these two in, which means I want another red source. I'm probably going to take out Temple Garden, because I think that I was like on one too many sources anyway. Probably taking out Narset, and I think taking out Smokestack. It's actually not good against their deck. Tangler also generally is not that good against the elves deck. I could put an Elesh Norn. Yeah, I can post a screenshot of the deck, sure. Mazemuth doesn't stop Gargaroth, really. I'm actually looking at this Winter Orb, too. I think Incinerate's worse than all those options, but it might be good enough. And I have enough red? Five, six. Yeah, I have enough. This is enough red. At this point, I might actually put in Goblin Welder because they don't really have a way to disrupt the Welder, though I guess I just took out some of the best Welder targets. So that's a little bit less appealing. Maybe I just keep the Winter Orb here. I don't know. I could put an Elesh Norn and maybe cut an island for a white source. Field of Ruin? Well, they played five forests last game in other land, so probably shouldn't put in Field of Ruin. I already added a red source. Nahiri is just a little bit worse. We cut three artifacts. Our metalwork is still going to be good. It doesn't have to reveal too much for it to be good. I don't really like Fetters against green. I'm kind of just thinking about just putting Winter Orb back in. I don't know. I've got a bunch of burn to stop their elves. My main problem with Elesh Norn is double white. I don't know. Maybe it's doable still. Yeah, this looks good. Yeah, maybe the Winter Orb should be an Elesh Norn. I guess Elesh Norn looks better in this hand because I'm probably going to Borosign out Golos to get a white mana. Can I explain why Smokestack is good? It basically lets you trade permanents for their permanents, and they all sack permanents before you do. It's a hard card to use, but if you have a lot of extra permanents lying around, you can really pressure them. The short answer that it's not is also reasonable. Like, I that is an acceptable answer. Fast Bond is not very good, like, in the mono green decks. I'm not going to say you shouldn't play Fast Bond, especially if you have Courser or Oracle, but in general, I find Fast Bond to be fairly weak in mono green because you're just down a card, and you kind of want all your cards to be mana sources. What's up, D-Ray the Great? 16 months. Welcome back. Hopefully this is something I can Mortars. It's not. Hey, thanks for the raid hat. Welcome, welcome. We've got a pretty nice little mono brown, or I guess blue-red wildfire deck, but lots of artifacts here. Yeah, we're playing against channelgargaroth.com, so... Ooh, Plow Under. Sure. I mean, Winter Orb looking pretty nice here, right? Like, I don't know, I'm not doing anything with my mana, so I might as well. What are you up to today, my friend? Last game they cast Channel and then played Elder Gargaroth off the channel. It was not an effective play to win the game. Lotus Cobra. Oh, there we go. Urza Winter Orb is just game. Top 10 with mono black vamps, Deece. Yeah, let's just go Urza. I had a thought of killing the Cobra with mortars, But like they're untapping one land. Like, what are they gonna do here? I mean, oh yeah, they're done. They're done. They just conceded. They just couldn't take it anymore. End of turn, I was gonna tap Winter Orb. That would have been, oh, that was gross. I would say I'm thankful we left Winter Orb in that game. Great call, me. I'm gonna pat myself on the back here. It's we when we punt, and it's me when I make good plays. Urza Winter Orb is pretty gross, yes. Not gonna lie. That was a real, yeah, that was a real easy clap. But what about win cons? Yeah, it doesn't really matter the deck. Everyone wants there to be more win cons. Because, I mean, it makes sense. Winning the game is like how you win the game, right? Like, oh, look at this. Turn on Workshop, Power Stone, turn two, Golos. We've got a turn three Wildfire or Upheaval or something on deck here. This is looking good. Yeah, but people basically stress way too much about win conditions in basically all decks. Is turn three Wildfire even good? Yeah, a lot of the times it will be. When you put them to no permanence in play and you still have like a Golos and you know, the ability to like then play a land and play something else, it's pretty good. I might just Upheaval instead. Who knows? I'm probably going to Golos for a Steam Vents here. I don't think they have Daze or Spell Pierce. Okay, yeah. They had something that was like a slightly harder decision. Good call from them. They wouldn't have been able to stop Golos. It's okay. I'm going to get to play Smokestack and grind them out. I would have liked to Crucible of Worlds in this deck. That would have been nice. Oh, geez. Trinket Mage and Mox. And Force of Negation. Looking pretty good so far. Okay. Draw. Smokestack and Payas. You have to decide which sorcery you're playing. Struggle playing Manor Island. That is not correct, because I get to Golos for a Steam Vents here. Stone Coil Serpent. So you want to stack it so you don't sack anything. I think I'm gonna put a counter on the Smokestack. I'm gonna go get Steam Vents here. Well, I know how to stack it. That's not what I'm worried about. I am going to get Steam Vents. Pass here. Springs, I like the way the sounds is, so I'm going to keep it this way. Not clear to me what I sack on upkeep to Smokestack here. Oh. Yeah, the workshop is not doing much for me here. Mm-hmm. The question is, do I want to put a second counter on it? I kind of don't. The problem is they just put this on that and then they hit. Yeah, I do too, BK. I think I just do this. Hope to draw Thrain Dynamo. Okay, Azorius Signet is not bad. They're going to get a hit with their Serpent here, but that's okay. Next turn, I'm going to get to cast something. I guess it has to be Upheaval. It's a little awkward. I wish I had still had my land drop. Tap Workshop, Upheaval, Replay Workshop, Golos is pretty sick. I can't sack any of my lands. I need them to cast these things. So that's why I let Smokestack go here. Hey, Mephistorium. We're not storming, but we are Upheaval Workshops here. They got Counterspell? Okay. Very reasonable play here. This actually is going to work out pretty nicely, I think. Because now I'm just going to cast Burning. I really have a hard time seeing them not counter it. And then next turn, I get to make the play that I mentioned earlier, where I go float three workshop mana, upheaval, replay workshop, play Golos. And hope they don't have another counter spell. Their deck looks pretty sweet. Okay, getting hit for six here. See, if I just had Academy Ruins, then you know, I'd still be fine here, but now I'm just losing all my good cards. Draw. Oh, wow. Oh, gross. That's bad. We need a... I don't know what we need now. And I guess play the Mana Crypt. Play Narset here. They weren't supposed to have that. I mean, I guess with Signet, I can Golos at some point here. Can't even Golos this turn, right? No. Yes, I needed Miscalc to be the top card and then cast it this turn. We're basically dead here, I think, but I suppose we can soldier on a little bit. I mean, we can't even Foff because we're just going to die to the sword if we do that. We cannot Golos. We do not have enough mana. Because this has Trample, so we can't even chump. This might be a tough matchup. Force of Negation in particular is really difficult for us to beat. And Counterspell and is no peach either. All right. Workshop does not work for Golos now. Walking Ballista's gone. Damn. Oh. I guess we redraw Upheaval. Well, I had to cycle to find the Golgari Signet, so... I wasn't really paying attention to this, but yeah, this works. Okay. They get to replay Vendilion Click, unfortunately. Oh, they didn't float mana? Okay. I don't know if we have enough win conditions left, though. Hold on. I needed my Walking Ballista to be in my deck still. Tezzeret's gone too. Let's see what we got. Urza. Urza might be able to, if I draw exactly Urza next turn, I don't get a land. I don't have an Academy, unfortunately. They're at 20. I mean, I guess they can play a 1-1 Stone Coil. So if I draw Urza this turn, I get two turns of attacking with Urza. It's still probably not enough, unfortunately. Yeah, I needed Tezzeret or Ballista to be in my decks. So I get to attack them to 17. No. Yeah, if I had Academy Ruins, I wouldn't have decked. Easy. I mean, I still want Wildfire against them. I'm just going to lose to their counter magic if they have it. I don't really know what I can do about that. I guess I can put Nahiri in. It can kill Sword. It can't kill Stone Coil because it's multicolored. They don't have artifact in their graveyard, so Welder does not really work. I mean, Welder works if they... Oh, it works against Sword, though. No, I like Welder for that reason. Oh, Maze of Ith also looks really good. All right, so I want those two. Maybe I do take out Burning and... Because if I take out Burning and this... Like, these cards are bad against a big Stone Coil, but they are kind of good otherwise. Oh, Nahiri can't even kill sword, yeah. Maybe do something like that. I kind of don't hate Elesh. Doesn't seem unreasonable. All right, Smokestack, you suck. Tanglewire could be good still, especially with Welder. Smokestack is also good with Welder, but I don't know how deep I want to go on that plan. I think I'm probably cut a mountain for like a shambling vent just to have another random Golos land. I don't think I want fetters. I like this. Think this is fine. Yeah, all right. Okay, well, we have turn two Golos again. So the good thing about this, which is actually funny, is they're probably not going to force a negation of Boros Signet because, like, why would you? Whereas Warren Powerstone did draw the force, which was a good play by them. Turn one, Stone Coil? Wonder what they have in their hand that would make that the play. Oh, now I draw it. Skull Clamp? Yeah, that's definitely a possibility. So I have blue, red, white. I'm just gonna get Maze of Ith, I think. But a sword, you would still wait till turn two. Unless they already had a two drop. I think Maze is probably better here than getting, because I can't get black green, so I can't fulfill Golos anyway. But I might as well attack here. But Maze is pretty nice against their equipment. Tinker also makes sense. Their deck definitely is a deck that could have Tinker in it. That's what, oh, Trinket Mage, all right. Bum, bum, bum. Trinky Dink. They got Mox Pearl was the power we saw game one. They also can get Stone Coil. So next turn. I'm not going to play Upheaval next turn, but I guess I could if I really want to. I'm actually kind of off this Tangler now. They have a lot of random junk to play. No reason to take a damage there. Golgari Signet would be an actually really good draw. Oh, Orzhov Signet, not the Signet I wanted. Trinket Mage definitely makes Upheaval worse, mostly because the Mox makes Upheaval worse. I don't really have an incentive to, like, oh, I have a Sensei's Top. I should just keep the Tarn in play. Don't think they're leaving a Manitai this much. There's no real downside to playing Mox Pearl. So I need to draw Temple Garden or Golgari Signet, and then I can start Golosing here. No, the reason I want to Maze the Golos is I don't want them to play some kind of equipment here. I'm more worried about, I don't know, like a GT getting GT counters on their own other things or something. If they don't attack me for both, I'll take 1 point of damage. I'm in for that. Control magic. Okay. Well, I couldn't activate it anyway. So now the question is, do I go for an upheaval while they're tapped out? I probably do. It's going to be a good upheaval, even if they get to Trinket Mage and reset their thing. Don't really have much I can do here. Because it lets me re-Golos as well. Obviously, they're going to force some negation me, but that's okay. Oh, they didn't. Okay. So now I have one. Let's see. So if I replay Mishra's Workshop, tap this, I can play Orzhov's Signet here. And then I can play Boros Signet. Yeah, and I have one real mana floating. Now I can double activate Signets and then use Golos artifact mana. And then now I want to get Temple Garden, right? Because that's the one thing I'm missing for Golos activations. Then I can actually Golos activation pretty fast here. The Mox does make this a bit worse. But they're still going to have to discard three cards here. Yeah, Temple Garden worked out pretty nicely here. 3, 4, 5. Let's see. Yeah, not this turn, but next turn I can activate Golos. So I play a land, they play a land. I play a land, activate Golos, then they have control magic. Yeah, that works for me. Getting one Golos activation is already pretty good. Battle Ball and Emrakul. Yeah, that looks to me like a... let's just Foff here. If we find... Because if we find a Tanglewire, we actually probably would just play it. Oh, are they going to Force of Negation us? Sure. Oh, Daze. Okay. Oh, I'm actually like... I don't even know if I'm... I think that's better for me than if it resolved. Oops. Getting dazed is... sets their control magic back by a turn. Yeah, that worked out really nicely. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now I have... Mountain... Mm-hmm. Yes, I said oops. That's why that's what the oops was, because I didn't attack. Mm-hmm. Hey, what up, Sponzy? I don't have any hasters, so I think attacking is fine. Yoink. Siggy, Narset. And I guess I'll pick up a miscalc. Really don't need any of these other things. Pass the turn. I don't think Svel is good enough for cube now. Too slow. Are they going to Vendilion click me again? They have that draw step stop, so it feels like they are. So can I leave up? I can leave up miscalc now. I don't really care if they click me in response to this. So I think I just Golos first. Because if I hit a land, I'd rather play it off Golos. It doesn't really matter, I suppose. Put my island, play Urza. And they know about balance, that's unfortunate. Hey, Rogers Knight, what's for dinner? What you got brewing? Counterspell my Urza. I will miscalculation the counterspell. They have control magic, but what are they going to control magic with? Both my cards are really threatening. It's actually really funny. Both my cards are very threatening, but also not that good for them. We will take Tez. And can't cast anything, so. Like they can take Golos, but then it's just a 3-5, a 3 being pure bloods. Or they can take Urza, which is a little better, but then I can't still have Golos. Hey, what's up, Nolas Void? Oh, a Trout Fillet seems decent. Oh man, I just cleaned the kitchen. Nice. Nice. Oh, they have their own Urza? I think they wanted to just control magic my Urza instead of playing their own, but whatever. Well, unless they have Time Walk. Oh no, they have a Stone Coil Serpent. Oh, that's not bad. So let's see. How much mana? So I can play Stone Coil or that. I guess I can probably Golos and then play Tez. Oh, yeah, that's fine. So. And then I can still probably cast all my things, assuming I hit some artifacts off this. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's exactly what I wanted to see. So let's go blue. I guess I have to play my land. Oh, actually, I don't have to. I can just plus one. I can untap those two. Then I can tap this. Eh, I'll just play my land. I don't need this shambling vent. Play Lodestone Golem. All right, this should do the trick, I would hope. I can attack them with my 9/9 too. Force a chump. Zero sum fun magic? Oh, I'm into it. Yeah. All right, they're a battler. They get to untap one land, then they have to tap four permanents to Tanglewire. Was that a good turn? Yeah, I would say that was a good turn. We're kind of living the dream here. Before game three, when their daze counterspell and force of negation just, you know, did us nicely. We've had two really good workshop starts here. Tapping the Winter Orb would let them untap their lands. I don't want to do that. Hey, what up, Sneaky Fat Kid? 28 months. Welcome. All right, I'm kind of off this Elesh Norn. I guess I could put in Face Fetters. I could put in Mizzium Mortars. It kills Urza, and it kills other things. Actually, I'm going to put in Ahiri, because I want to kill... I'll take out Tanglewire, too. Because I want to kill Control Magic. I think that's actually good. I think I still have enough white sources. Do I want... Yeah, I think Fetters is probably the second card. All right. That's my plan here. I'm going to keep this. They can't all be workshop hands. They can't all be turn two Golos hands. This hand would love to see a Signet, though. That would be nice. It must be nice. It must be nice. Is Golos the magic equivalent of Discover? That's a good comparison, because Discover is really fun. Everyone loves Discover. It must not be nice to draw two lands in a row. Because now I don't really want to play a 1-1 Ballista. I don't think it's good. Actually, I'm going to play a 1-1 Ballista. So here's the reason. First of all, I could eat a Counterspell or Daze and be fine with that. Second, this stops Vendilion Click. And one of the things I'm worried about is playing Narset into Vendilion Click here. And then on turn four, if I don't have any plays, so I can just make this into a 2-2. So it's not really that different from playing a 2-2 Ballista. Let's play Narset here. I need to stop drawing lands, though, especially since this is probably going to get countered. Yeah, sure. Well, I mean, Ballista is still pretty good. Also, Maze of Ith seems kind of good against their deck. They do seem like they try to interact with creatures. Oh. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm not playing Maze here, which could punish me a bit, but I don't really want to miss a land drop right now. I haven't drawn a spell yet, which is unfortunate. Well, we'll see what they're up to. They're not going to hit me a sword this turn unless they have a mox, so that's nice at least. Man, this is rough, because I don't really want to play Tezzeret into a 2-2 attacker. Oh, that's interesting. All right, let's play Tez. Drawing balance is good. So now Tez gets countered. All right, so did not get countered. I'm going to remove one loyalty counter. Sensei's Divining Top. Because I assume that the Sower is going to attack Tezzeret down to one. This also hedges against them killing it in some other form or fashion. Mold Drifter? Okay. That's not too bad. Because now I can maybe do a little balance action here. Would I consider Ravenous Chupacabra iconic? I would not. I don't really want to lose Tez here. So let's go Siggy. All Okay. There's no way to tap top and then untap it with Tez. No, that's not a thing. So I have five lands. They have six lands. So the question again is, do I want to blow up one of their lands or make them discard a card? That's really, that is it. That is the, that's the $1 million question. I still think I'd rather make, blow up a land here, but I don't know. I guess their curve is not very high. No, I'm going to play a land. I'll make them discard extra cards. I think that making them discard the second card also adds up, and I can already pay for days, so I don't need to use Tez yet. I'm going to play... I like playing Maze here because I want to get that thing into play. I don't know. Maybe I should have played the island, I guess. Who knows? Most iconic card not in Alpha Beta Unlimited. I don't know. That's a good question. They discarded a land, so nah, whatever. Jace the Mind Sculptor. Yeah, that's pretty good. Not a bad one. Tezzeret looking pretty good here. Juzam Jin? No, I think Jace is going to be... like, if you look at the number of people who know who Jace is, it's just way higher than a lot of these other cards. Five mana. This is a Stone Coil. Oh, Yorion. Okay. Well, I guess I'm glad I killed the Muldrifter. This Maze of Ith is looking real good. Oh, yeah, you exiled the top. Sweet. Draw. So let's see. Urza. I'm going to play Urza. And then I think, let's see, one, two, three. I guess I can go tap and untap, add blue, untap these two, and then spin Urza. Yeah, this looks pretty good to me because it also shuffles. Yeah, I'll play Mana Crypt. I'm at 18 because then I get to Urza again. Oh, wait, no, I don't. I lied. The Maze of Ith does not, in fact, tap for mana. Do I want to use top here? I guess I got punished for using Tezzeret before spinning Urza. I didn't really think of hitting Mana Crypt and untapping that. Oh, well. Mere Battle Ball. Okay. That's, like, a little annoying. Please don't attack with you. All right, whatever. I get a lot of looks to find upheaval here. So I'm not too worried. Okay. So now I could spin Urza on upkeep because I still think I can cast upheaval even if I draw it, right? Yeah. Okay, heads. I guess I'll spin top again. No, yeah, I'll spin top again here. Nahiri the Harbinger. No, I can't even cast Nahiri. I can also fetch Tez to shuffle if I want, is the thing. Yeah. So I'm going to get to play this mountain. Oh, I could cast Nahir if I wanted to, actually. I have this mountain. Yeah, let's see. What am I going to do? Am I going to... I mean, I guess the Tezzeret's dying. I could get Winter Orb here. Yeah, this is fine. I don't really need the other signets and stuff. So let's draw... I'll play this mountain. I'm going to get Winter Orb here. And then I could spin top. I don't actually want to play Nahiri here. So bad if you had upheaval or upkeep. That is not true. You have until end of turn to play the thing. Let's see. So if I look, Four. Yeah, I have enough mana that if I find upheaval here, I can still cast it. Okay, I didn't. So now the question is, would I rather cast Goblin Welder or spin with Urza? I'd rather just spin with Urza, I think. Playing a Hurrying Kill Battle Ball. It is not tapped, unfortunately. Okay, we did like a decent amount of bricking there, but I don't think we're like in that bad of shape. I don't know, like what are they going to do this turn? Like, they could attack me for 8, put me to 10. It's really not that bad. Tapping, topping when you have a, when there's a Winter Orb out is a little rough. Like, if they want to kill my Tezzeret, they have to send the Mirror Battlesphere at the Tezzeret. And then I can just Maze the Yorian, so I take 0. So I'm just like pretty happy either way. I actually don't feel like I'm in bad shape. And then I get to go Nahiri, and I guess they could attack me with these two and put 2 at Tezzeret or 3 at Tezzeret. And then I block a mirror, Maze the Yorian, or maze the mirror, I take 5. Yeah, so I guess the best they can probably do is sack a mirror to deal some damage. Sure. Urza Winter Orb is pretty nice, yes. Mm-hmm. Leaving Tez up means you get to tap the Winter Orb and untap it EOT. Tez does not interact with the Winter Orb at this point in the game. Mm-hmm. Urza does, though. I actually think we're doing fine here. Yeah, Julian, I don't think that they're going to reprint Winter Orb. I'm not really expecting that one. Legacy Horizons, they could if they did want to do something like that. But didn't Modern Horizons have like 0 reprints or something? I don't remember. It'll depend on what's going on. I know I can't Nahiri it if I maze it, but like I also next turn get to see just a ton of cards. Like, because I already Tezzed here, so I get to upkeep top. It had reprints from, yeah, okay, that makes sense. Mole. This is not the simplest attack step, though I think I figured out what they should do. Yorian at me, mirror at me, 3 mirrors at Tezzeret, tap 1 mirror to Battlesphere. Oh, they figured out the next best play. I was going to top, then I was going to top again, and then I was going to find upheaval in the second one, because that's how it works. There we go. Could this be a double trophy day? Ooh, if so. Big if true. Chad, I did the first workout today that I've done in a really long time. I have a personal trainer. His name is Jean, and it was via like Zoom or Discord or whatever, but like it was good. I'm looking forward to being sore tomorrow. Didn't start off too fast because it's been quite a while, but you know, you got to start somewhere. It's like the old saying, when's the best time to plant a tree? Well, 20 years ago. What's the second best time now? You know, that sort of thing. Do, do, do. All right, let's go. Sponzy, stop. Classic Sponzies. Oh, the Spindrift is still empty. It's actually pretty unfortunate that it's still empty. Every time I pick it up, ooh. Balance, Dece. Yeah, I know what you mean, Rebecca. I do like the fact that I'm playing against a Thraben Inspector deck, maybe White Weenie, and I have Balance and Wildfire in my hand. Mm-hmm. turn two, I get to go Seachrome Coast, Boros Signet. I could also play... Black White. Bitter Blossom. Okay, well, all the cards I named are fairly good against Bitter Blossom. I'm just going to play the Boros Signet here. Tangleware, not so great. The reason I want to play Boros Signet instead of leaving up Miscalc is if it was a blue Signet, I would might wait a turn because you could go leave up Miscalc, then next turn Signet, leave up Miscalc, the classic curve. But because I can't, and because Balance is pretty good against most things they could cast next turn, I think I'm happier doing this. Of course, if they play like a Liliana here or a Tide Hollow Skull, that's going to be tough. Lingering Souls. No, that's okay. Tangleware is looking like feces. I will say that. But I can just discard it to Balance. So I'm taking 4 damage next turn. I can live with that. I can live with that. And I've got some cards to discard. Also, I might... Let's see. If I take 4 plus 5... Yeah, I might just take... Just take 2 hits and then just cast Burning and not even cast Balance right now. Oh yeah. Tangleware and Smokestack, they are out of here. I guess I might take... It would be 4 plus 7. I'm probably in for Flashback Souls here. I do want them to crack this clue, which they looks like they have a good chance of doing. And actually really like saving the Balance here because first of all, I don't have to discard a bunch of cards. Second, it's good. It's a good thing for me to cast post Wildfire when I balance or Wildfire down to 1 land plus Signet here. What's up, Tommy Jones? Yeah, I'm having a very good night. This is round 3. Hopefully they play something that dies. Well, miscalculating that doesn't really do much, does it? No. I mean, we'll see. We'll see what happens here, huh? Good beats. Good beats. Good beats. What can you do? Ooh, Mana Tithe got in there. All right, well, we definitely want Pyroclasm and Elish Norn, Shambling Vent, and I guess Mizzium Mortars. Yeah, they were ready. They were ready. Tangleware, Smokestack can go out. Island can go out. And probably Narset is just not good against decks that just play to the board here. Winter Orb might still be good. The Winter Orb Urza combo is really broken. It's like you blow up all their lands and all your lands are still there. I don't think killing Bitter Blossom is like a super high priority for me. Nahiri might still be good if they have if they're like black white mid range here. I was not expecting it just to work smoothly. Both Lapse of Certainty and Mana Tithe get me there, you know. Lyra, my problem with Lyra is people never take out the removal, so they just kill it. I don't know. Yeah, kind of like this. Maybe I want Nahiri. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, I could have gone for a Balance earlier, but that seemed like I think the play I made was the highest upside, so. The problem with balancing is I have to either discard, I have to discard multiple cards, and then they still have the Bitter Blossom out, and then they replay something and I can't really Wildfire. I don't know, not great. I don't know what's up with this Grim Monolith and this Mana Vault in their deck. That one seems like a little dangerous. All right, so I'm gonna play this. The question now is, what do I play next turn? Is it Foff or is it Metalworker? I mean, Metalworker, having Metalworker and play 4 Foff is pretty nice. Could also play Golgari Signet and Metalworker. Yeah, I mean, if they have like a couple expensive cards, these make sense. Obviously. Most decks are just put Mana Vault in their deck. It's just a good card. But a really low curve deck, I don't know. That's not always going to work out. Like, we'll see. Off the cup, top 3 fruits of all time. I mean, my favorite fruit is avocado, but obviously if you're not asking like tomato and avocado, I don't know, probably like blackberries. bananas, and I don't even know what the last one would be. I think I'm gonna get a little greedy here and just play it this way. Yeah, I guess I don't even know what number three would be. Strawberries, probably. So I didn't play the Signet because if they do kill the Metalworker, I can still go Signet plus Foff. Okay, here we go. Wormcoil? Okay. I'm not super scared of Wormcoil. Okay. Let's cast Factor Fiction here. If they mana tithe it, ooh, that's the gamble. Do they mana tithe it with a Metalworker in play? Oh, they do. Okay. That works for me. Yep. Not this time. What do we say? To the God of Death? Not today. I love all berries, to be honest. So it's Ballista or Busto? I'll take Ballista. That's fine. So, let's see. I can make a 3-3 Ballista. Is that good? Then next turn, I'll have 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Like a 5-5 Ballista. Or I can wait a turn, and this is, let's see, 4, 5, 11. I think I just wait a turn here. I wouldn't mind a Ballista, like, nugging a Wormcoil engine. That was a gutsy move. Though, it also does... Part of the reason you want to mana tithe there is because it prevents me from revealing the Foft cards to Metalworker. I'm a little worried about like a Mind Twist sort of thing, but they would have just Mind Twisted me instead of playing Wormcoil. They would be deranged to play Wormcoil first, so. I don't want to take too many hits if I'm going to play this Mana Crypt, though. Braid, okay. Well, that actually works out kind of nicely because I did. Now I can balance the Wormcoil into two dorks. I was hoping they would play another thing. Oh, I see. Hey, Fragantoad, the 32 months. Welcome back. Yeah, now it's got to just be like Urza. Into a Ballista, I think. Well, 13. Let's just play Signet. Let's just pass for a turn here. Like I said, I really don't want to play Mana Crypt because I think I want to take another hit off this. I don't want to, but I'm going to take another hit off this Wormcoil here. And then I can start like spinning with Urza. I might at some point chump with the token or a Ballista. I also might be able to, and we'll see what they do. It looks like they've got a play, but like cough? Okay. I did not anticipate that. But I guess I get to kill cough next turn anyway. Interesting. Okay, I'll take 10. Yeah, I couldn't tell you what's going on exactly. So now I can play a Ballista for a 3-3 Ballista, and this would be a 4-4. Got a couple ways I can do this. I can like play a Ballista for 3. I think I'm actually gonna spin Urza, and here's my plan. Spin Urza, kill Koth with the token after playing a Ballista here. Cause at the very worst I hit land. Oh, I hit Golos? Okay. That was a hit. Definitely going to bring in Maze of Ith here, which I probably should have... Well, against all the tokens, it kind of made sense not to have it in. But now... Oh, now I could get Workshop, though. Actually, Shambling Vent. I think I'm just going to get Shambling Vent because then go to one here. Actually, no, I'm not going to go to one. I'm going to use Urza, tap Golos, tap this, play a Ballista for one. And then attack Koth with the Construct and kill it. And then I have two chump blockers. Okay, here we go. And now I've got Golos plus Urza going, which should be able to outpace a Worm Coil. Like, I'll just block with Ballista and ping. At this point, playing a huge Ballista, I think, is worse than activating these things. And they even get to not gain life this turn. All right, there we go, there we go. Okay. Okay, okay, that's making my life hard. Oh man, really? Three. I drew Winter Orb, but I had to have drawn that too. Damn. I'm not going to attack here. This is a kind of awkward spot where. No, playing the Crypt is just not going to work out. I just can't. I have to win before Crypt dies. What am I doing here? So. I could double block the Worm with those. This involves trading everything away, but so I double block the Worm with Urza and the Construct. It kills both. They make two tokens. And then I balance to get them down to one token. I think that's better because I'm just not going to have enough mana to do things. I guess I could untap. Like, I could untap a land and then spin with Urza. But then I'm chumping with Golos or something? This doesn't seem like it works. One more artifact would be nice. I could triple block. Sure. I suppose that's true. They drew an instant? Kolaghan's Command? Yikes. All right, well, I guess I'm glad I didn't triple block. All right. sure, a Shambling Vent could do something. Why not Shatter Golos? I don't know, they just didn't play great. Couldn't explain it. Wow, this is a really rough spot. Some are just dying so badly to this Worm Coil engine. I think I just chump with Golos. I don't really think I gain anything by blocking. This is a deck that we lost to, yes. Upheaval? I mean, we're not technically dead because we have the Shambling Vent, but yeah. I mean, I could balance to put them down, Worm Coil into 2 3-3s, but then I just die. Well, I guess I don't just die, but it's still, I don't see how that's better. It is a little annoying losing with our sick Workshop deck to a Mardu Artifacts Mana Tithe deck, but the Mana Tithe God is good. That's what the card does. This is the best I've ever seen Worm Coil Engine be. I'll tell you that. Lingering Souls, sure. I'm at 5 now, so I guess there are outs. Yeah, no. Good beats. Not quite a double trophy day, but that was still pretty fun. I did enjoy that game. Well, not that game. The draft was good. That game was a little painful, but you know what? It's what it is. Boo, boo, boo. Oh, that was a wild ride. There were some swings. So if you enjoyed that video, check out channelfireball.com. Lots more videos like that. Also brought to you by our sponsor, Ultimate Guard. All right.